Welcome to Solving with AWS Solutions, your deep dive into reference architectures built by AWS that are ready to deploy instantly in the cloud. I'm Allison, and I'm here with Matt today, who's going to tell us about the Media Services Application Mapper solution. We call MSAM for short.
MSAM visualizes the relationship among multiple media services in a common video workflow. It flags alarms in your workflow in real time as soon as they arise.
Let's see how this works. Matt, I want to deploy MSAM. Where do I go?
So we're going to go ahead and hop into the solutions page. So on this page, you're going to see that there's a solution name, a brief description, some of its benefits and workflows. But really where we want to talk about is the implementation guide and a link to the source code so you can download it, make it your own, and finally, the architecture itself.
Okay, yeah, can we focus in on the architecture? I'd love to learn more.
Yeah, let's go ahead and enlarge it, and here we go. So on the architecture here, you're going to notice that there is a lot of components and there's a lot of different pieces involved. So let's go ahead and start in the center. So in the center, we're going to talk about Lambda. And Lambda is really going to be your aggregator of data. It's collecting all the information about your workflows, what's going on, all the different interconnected pieces, and really piping that into DynamoDB, as well as we're grabbing information from Dynamo and aggregating it to make sure it's accurate and it's consistent. So we also pull data, if you look in the lower right-hand corner right here, from Amazon CloudWatch. So CloudWatch is going to be monitoring all your other instance types, your Amazon EC2 instances, as well as your other resources that are related to your broadcast workflows.
And which AWS media services are supported by this?
So if we look in the center of the map, we're going to start looking at all our media workflows, and we're going to talk about our AWS Elemental products. So that's going to be Elemental Media Connect, as well as Link, and really to function and pull any type of video workflows.
Okay, can I see this in action?
Let's go ahead and deploy it. So we're going to go ahead and click that magic button of launching it in the console. So within the console, it's going to load in and it's going to populate all of the data that you need. So it's going to have the template information as well as the ability to just click next so we can move forward. From here, we've already populated a name and a time to live. These are variables that you can change. You can rename it, you can change your time to live it to be whatever you want it to be. So we'll click next, we'll scroll down, go ahead and click next, and right at the very bottom, we're gonna accept the terms and then finally create stack so we can deploy the solution.
Okay, but are there any other steps that I need to getting online?
I'm happy you asked. There are just a couple more steps as soon as it's done being deployed. So we're gonna change over and go over here. We're gonna look at the outputs tab. Now that we've deployed the solution, it created some data for us. And one of the really important pieces of data you need is the endpoint URL. That's where you're gonna connect to. But you also need your API key. So in your API key, we're gonna go ahead and click and go over to Amazon API Gateway. And from here, we're gonna go ahead and click this little button here that says show for our API key. We're gonna go ahead and highlight and copy that because we're gonna need both the endpoint URL and the API key to make sure that we get the solution fully deployed.
Okay, that seems critical, of course. So we've talked about flags and alerts. Where would I see that?
So let's just dive right into it. So in the solution itself, we can see we already have a couple workflows already created. And if you notice, they're green. Green means good. When we see yellow and red, that means there's probably some problematic components of that workflow, some errors, maybe a video feed that's gone down. But as an example, let's dive into Portland. So for Portland, we can show and we can instantly see, here's our video workflow. We can see our source, okay, our distribution points, and really how we intended this production to work.
And if there were an error, I would see that flagged somewhere here.
Yeah, not only is it visualizing the workflow, but you'd see that red error, or you'd actually see some flags along the way showing that there's a problem.
Okay, that's fantastic. So I could just plug this in on top of my OTT service today.
That's really the point, to make it really easy to visualize your distribution feeds, your consumption feeds, just make it easy to really just go.
All right, I love it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Matt, thanks so much for reviewing the Media Services Application Mapper solution with me today.
Please check out this solution and many more on the AWS Solutions website.
Thanks for watching. We hope to see you again soon.